Okay, so we defined homotopy, path homotopy, product of paths, and then also product of paths was written as this, F times G, okay? And then also the product of homotopy classes of paths.
So this is
well defined, okay? And now we want to construct this group, fundamental group. So we need the first lemma. Three lemma. First one, lemma one. So this is associativity. So, well, F times G with this notation times H is equal to F times G times H. So this is trivial. So this means maybe this and this is this. So this is associativity, okay, of this product. So what does it mean? F and the product has to be defined always, okay? This means G starts where F ends in the point, and H starts where G ends, okay? Otherwise the product is not defined. Then this is all defined, okay? So this is the proof. And I will not write, well, proof. I will indicate the what do we have to prove? So we have to prove that this is equal to this. This means that F, we have to prove that first this is F times G times H. And the class of this is the same as here. This is first F and then G times H. And so they represent the same class, so they are homotopic. That we have to prove, okay? So we have to define a homotopy between this and this, okay? And this I will do schematically. So I make my picture. I will not write the formula. In the book, you find the formulas, but this is not so interesting. I mean, it's clear that let's see what happens. So this product here, okay? This is the interval, 0, 1, okay? The homotopy. So the first one, F times G times H, what does it mean? So it means we have H here, and we have F times G here. Half interval, half interval. F times G, however, is also a product, okay? So we go F with 4 times the original velocity, okay? Between 0 and 1 over 4. Then we go G, also 4 times velocity, between 1 over 4, 1 over 2, and H twice, 2 times velocity, okay? This is the parametrization, right? Between 0, 1 over 4, 1 over half. Instead, on this side, we have just another parametrization. The path doesn't change, okay? The parametrization changes. The image doesn't change. So what we have here, we have first F. This is twice velocity, okay? And then we have GH. So it's this one, the parametrization, right? And now we have to define H here. Everywhere, okay, on all levels, okay? So we want to define this H. So our space, what is it? X, okay? Homotopy, where are we in X? Wherever we are, there's no name. So these are passes in X, okay? F, G,
H passes in some space, which is always X.
So what would you suggest what to do? Well, we have to define H. It's defined here. By the product, it's defined here. Here it should be constant anyway, right? So path homotopy means constant here. So in which point? F of 0, in the initial point of F. This is always the point. This is fixed, okay? This is path homotopy. Here it's constant path in the final point of H, no? Everything else here, okay? So constant here, here this here, and we have to define it everywhere, okay? So what you do is you make some thing in this way, and then you want to do, say, what on an intermediate level t, what should be this, so this is t between 0 and 1, this is level 0, this is level 1 in t, what we do, okay? How we define the map, okay? And it's clear that we just change parameterizations, okay, from this parameterization to this. So we want to take f here also, okay, but this is a parameterization between 4 times the velocity and 2 times the velocity, okay? So we decrease the velocity from 4 times to 2 times here, right? This interval is 0, 1 over 4, this is 0, 1 over half, okay? So just a question of parameterization. And then we have a g here. This is 4 times velocity, okay? Between the interval is of length 1 over 4, this one, okay? And here it's also 1 over 4. I didn't write the points. So it's the same velocity. That doesn't change now, g. But the interval, okay, changes, no? Here we are from, 1 over 4 to 1 over half. Here we are from 1 over half to 3 over 4, okay? And here we have go back, okay? So the velocity is the same, but the interval where it's defined, this g, will change here, okay? And then we take here h. This we have to reparameterize also, okay? So so we have to, all these three things have to reparameterized, okay? The velocity and also the interval we have to.
Reparametrization.
And now you can write formulas, okay? If you want, you have to find this equation of this, and then in this area, this, in this area, this, in this area, and you have for some algebraic, okay? But I'm not interested in that, okay? That's in the book, but it's... It's clear that if you sit down 1 hour, then in some way you find, okay, an explicit formula. You have two coordinates, this and this, right? Both are intervals, and then for, but this is not very interesting. I mean, it's clear that you can do that, okay, in a continuous way. And I don't know the formula. I didn't, I mean, it's in the book, but I'm not interested. Okay, and so this defines H. The homotopy between this and this, okay? Anyway, there's a small lemma. By the image of this path and this path is the same. The image is the same, no? But it's a reparametrization, okay? This path upstairs, and they are not equal here. That's important, okay? That's not, we don't have associativity for the paths itself. This path upstairs here, this one, downstairs and upstairs, they are not equal, okay? Why are they not equal? The image is the same, but it's a different parameterization. So two passes are the same if everything is the same, as maps, okay? Not just the image, but also the parameterization. So they differ by a parameterization, all these passes here, okay? It's always the same image, but different parameterizations, right? That's a general fact, by the way.
So this is an exercise, if you want.
If you reparameterize, what is a so f is the path.
F from I to x, some path. And now I want a reparameterization of this path, okay?
What does it mean? Well, in general, you take a diffeomorphism, homeomorphism of the interval, okay, and compose. So let f a path and r mapping from I to I. In general, diffeomorphism, homeomorphism, whatever. But that's not so important. Continuous.
Even continuous. Such that, map, such that. So the only thing which I want is that the initial point goes to the initial point, the end point to the end point. I don't want something strange with these points. Such that R of 0 is 0. And R of 1 is 1.
Okay? They preserve the endpoint of the endpoint. The rest only continues.
Then the exercise says then F, and now I take first R and then F. So I want to call this a reparametrization of F, okay? Reparametrization of F.
Maybe you want R to be a homeomorphism then, okay? But that doesn't matter. Continuous is sufficient. Then this R homotopic. A path homotopic, of course. That's an exercise for next week. It's easy. Okay? This exercise. The first exercise, okay? So if you reparameterize the path in this sense, then the homotopy class is the same, okay? This is easy. We are in the interval, okay? In the interval. In the interval, we have some, no? This is straight line homotopy type, okay? So this works.
Then I give a second exercise immediately.
So yesterday I made a special case, which also this is very easy. So it's exercise one next week. This is exercise one, so exercise two. Because yesterday I wanted to do that, but I made a special case only. this exercise, this is our reparametrizations, clearly, okay, of the past, no? And then you can define this R, which maps this to this, this to this, and this H to this in a linear way, okay? That's a reparametrization. So if you want, this implies this, okay? So exercise two, that's what I wanted to do yesterday. So I give you an exercise, a very easy exercise. Two for next week. So this says that if F
and G from X to Rn are continuous maps. So we have two continuous maps to Rn again, okay? Then F and G are homotopic. Not path homotopic, not paths, okay? No. Continuous maps, then F and G are homotopic. This is very easy.
What I showed yesterday, I wanted to show this yesterday, no? And then what I showed is that any map from X to Rn is homotopic to a constant map, okay? But don't use this. Prove directly this, okay? Any two maps to Rn are homotopic. From a space X to Rn are homotopic, no? So how's the homotopy called, of course? What homotopy? What is the name of this homotopy? Yes, of course. Okay, straight line. We are in Rn and then we use straight line homotopy, okay? Okay, so this is also. That's what I wanted to do and then I made only a special case. Well, that's the first. The these are two exercises, okay? And now we have associativity of this product And now we have, we need what else?
Lemma 2.
We need a unit element, okay? If we want a group. So if f
from I to x is a path, a continuous mapping, no?
Then we need something which looks like a unit element, and f
times.
So this would be a constant path, okay? So this has to be a constant path
in the endpoint of f, right? Otherwise the product is not defined.
So this goes from f of 0 to f of 1, and then we have the constant in f of 1, okay?
Is equal to f. This the homotopy class, and also the other way. Only that I have to write now f of 0, the constant path in f of 0 times f is also f.
Now I have to write f of 0, no? Constant path. And then this has a start where this ends. Okay? Otherwise the product is not defined. So this is the second lemma. And here we have, in principle, we may apply this again here, this also proof.
But I make it,
what you have to, let's prove the first one. F times, we have to prove
so the first one is F times constant path F1 is homotopic, this means homotopic to F.
Okay, that's what it says, this one. Right? That we have to prove.
So we have to define again homotopy here. Homotopy in this instance.
And now we look what
we do the same kind of picture.
So I want to define this H
to X. So let's
look at this. So we have F times constant path. So how is the parameterization of this? Half of the time interval for the first, the other half for the second.
So here we have f,
right?
And here we have all this constant in the endpoint of f, f of 1.
That's this product, okay? Here.
Here, instead, we want f,
okay? The normal f, okay? So you may apply this exercise, no? It's not exactly a reparameterization. You have a map from here to, I mean, the image is the same, right? But what happens here is you go f, okay? What happens here, you go f with twice velocity and then you stay in the endpoint for the rest of the time, right? That's what happens. Here you just have f, okay?
Some f.
That's f. What happens here? You go f also, but you go twice the velocity, okay? Twice as fast.
So you go twice as fast, the same path, and then for the second half of the time interval, from one half to one, you just stay in this point.
You relax, okay? Here you go with the normal velocity. Here you go twice velocity, and then from between 0 and 1 half, and between 1 half and 1, you relax and stay in this point, okay? That's the second part, this one, right? No parameterization or not. So I said only a continuous map, right? We need this continuous map from here to here to reparameterize, okay? By homeomorphism, this is difficult because, but we may map this to this by mapping all this to this point, okay? And this to this, in the sense of the first exercise, this is a reparametrization. It's not a homeomorphism, no, because this interval goes to one point. Okay, so here we want a constant map in which point f of 1. Here we want constant map in f of 0, no, on this side, pass homotopy. So in the sense of exercise 1, also this is a reparametrization. It's not a homeomorphism now, because the whole interval gets to one point, okay? But it's no problem. So either you apply this, or you, again, at the time t, you say what you want to do, okay? And then there are the formulas, again, which I don't know. And so this is time t. And so what you do? Well, it's clear. You do this, for example. This, okay. And then you take f here, but reparameterize. Now here you have twice velocity, here you have the original. And here you pass from twice to the original velocity, okay? And the time interval changes. And here on this part, you take everything constant. So here it's everything is constant here, okay? So here it's constant on this part. Constant in this point f of 1, in this whole area here. Okay. So this is, and you see, they are not equal again, okay? They are not equal, because they have the same image, but different parameterizations, okay? So they are not equal as passes. We have to pass to homotopy classes of passes to have equality here, okay? It's not true for the passes itself, okay? This pass and this pass, in general, are very different passes, okay? The image is the same, but they are different. Two maps are equal. A pass is a map, right? A continuous map. Two maps are equal if they're equal for each t in the interval, right? And these are not equal, obviously. So it's the equality we have for the homotopy classes of passes, not for the passes itself, okay? Here we have only homotopic, but not equal. Is that clear? We have to pass the homotopy classes. And then there's a third lemma. The second is the same, okay, obviously. It is almost. So the third lemma is lemma 3. We need what? We need inverse elements, okay? So let f from I to x be a path again. So we have a candidate for the inverse, no? So define f minus 1. From I to X by, well, if you have F in this direction, and now you just go back, the same path, okay? So you change, F minus 1. So you change, okay, the direction. So F minus 1 by F minus 1 of T is equal to what? 1 minus T, no? So you go back, yes. Then f times f minus 1. Sorry, I'm lost. What? This is not correct, right? F of 1 minus t. Yeah, right, of course. Yes. What did I write? 1 minus t just, no? F of 1 minus t. Yes, right. F of 1 minus t. Okay, the f, of course, no? 1 minus t is. Okay, then this is, so what should it be? Constant path. So this is passed from f of 0 to f of 1. This goes back from f of 1 to f of 0. So f of 0. The endpoints of the product are f of 0 on both sides. So
and f minus 1 times f is now, what should I write?
F of 1 now, okay? We start in f of 1 and we finish in f of 1.
So f of 1.
Okay. Well, you see the homotopy here, okay? And let me make the picture, so proof. We have to fix only the endpoints, right?
So proof, again, proof. We have to prove what we have to prove.
The first one is f times f minus 1, not equal in general, homotopic to gf0 by a homotopy h again, okay? And then the second one in a similar way. Let's look at this. So this means
I have to define this h again, this homotopy h,
okay? And between this,
here we have f,
and then f minus 1, okay? So this is f minus 1. And here we have the constant map at time for the homotopy, okay? And here we have what? The constant map. And here we have, again, the same, here we have the same constant on all sides, okay? And now the homotopy is the following. So again, so what can you do? Well, well, the one thing which you may try this one, okay? And then again, I'd say at a level t, what do I want to do? How do I want to define this map, okay? And here we are in the point f of 1, right? So here's the constant. This is the point f of 1. Here we have the this f of 0 constant. So here f of what? 1 minus t, no? And then we go between f of 1 and f of 0, okay? 1 minus t. And here, on this part, we take f, but not the whole f now, okay? So what we do is, at time t, we go just to a certain point, okay? Then we remain at this point, and then we go back.
F minus 1, but also here restriction, okay?
So I have to write maybe the restriction to what? And then we have to reparameterize, of course, everything, okay? So we stay here. So this is f restriction, and then we go back with f minus 1 restricted to, okay, and reparameterized. And then at time, this is at time 0 and at time 1, we just stay all the time in this point, okay? So here in the immediate, we go just a little bit, we stay a long time here, and then we go back, and finally we stay all the time. This is a homotopy, intuitively, okay? Which I'm describing here. So f restriction to what? To 0 t, t, it depends on t. 1 minus t, yeah. Because here is 0. Yeah. So if t is equal to 1, this is 0, 0. So this is, okay. 1 minus t. Yeah, right, 1 minus t. that's okay. And then we have f1 minus t, okay, anyway. And then we return f minus 1 restricted to... So what is the interval here? 1. It's t. Okay. I think this is okay. Okay? Well, anyway, this is a homotopy, okay? At time t, you go just you start at 0 and you go to 1 minus t, okay? Then you stay here and then you go back with f minus 1. Okay, that's it. You can have a look in the book and then you find the formulas, okay? If you don't like this. But they are sort of more technical to write down. So now you don't define a group. Fundamental group. So the product, of course, has to be defined always in a group, okay? Now we have a path, and we have a product of paths, but we need that the second path starts in the endpoint of the first path. Otherwise, so we take closed paths, okay? So let X be a so definition.
So X is a topological space. And x0 is a fixed point in x. So pi 1 of x0 is equal to.
So you take all closed paths f
from I to x such that f of 0 is equal to f of 1 is equal to x0.
So this is a closed path. You say a closed path.
Same endpoint and initial point.
A loop sometimes, okay? A loop.
Well, I don't know.
So f zero f is a path, of course. Here f is a path. No, sorry. Well, I want to have homotopy classes of paths. So I'm sorry.
So I take f,
the homotopy class of f,
where f from I to x.
It's a path.
A closed path. Anyway,
it must be a path. Continuous. The homotopy class of all loops which start and finish in this point, no?
So the picture is clear.
Closed passes. This is called the fundamental group. Of x with base point x0, based at x0, with base point x0. This is the base point. We have to choose a base point, fix a base point. So this x0 is fixed. And
then we have this.
Why is it a group now? What is the product? Of course, the product is, now the product is always defined, okay?
So we have the product is our product of passes. So F times G. So these are closed passes now. This is F times G, of course. This is always defined. That's the only remark here. Always defined now. Because all passes start and finish in the same point, okay? So it's always defined.
It's associative, okay? That's a special case of lemma I. By lemma one,
the product is associative.
Okay. What is the unit element? Cx0, okay?
Cx0
is a unit element
by lemma 2. This is lemma 2.
And inverse,
so F
inverse element is the class of the inverse path, so F minus 1. So this is F minus 1. And this is lemma 3, okay? And so what else? So it's a group. That's it. We don't, that's the three things we need, no? So
well, this implies pi 1 x, x 0 is a group.
And this is a fundamental group of x with base point, x 0. That's the definition. Example.
Pi 1, a fundamental group of Rn with some base point, whatever that is, 0.
Well, that's the next question. The role of the base point, okay? Does it depend on the base point or what happens with the base point? So let's take 0 here, is a trivial group.
What means trivial group? So this means it's, it has just one element, and that's the unit element, okay? So C, 0, that's the only element, okay?
It's a trivial group. It's just a unit element.
Well, proof. That's again, here you have x0, and we have to prove that
any path, any loop, is homotopic to this constant loop, okay? That's the only homotopy class. So
we have some f here in the fundamental group, right?
Represented by f, no, by the path. And now we have to prove F is homotopic
to the constant map in the point 0 by some homotopy H, okay?
Now we are in Rn. It's always straight line homotopy. What will you do?
So you just let these points go back, right?
So what is the definition of this homotopy? So
H of ST is equal to
the only thing we have F, no?
F of, so what should I write?
F of S is the original path, no?
S times T. Or 1 minus t times s. It doesn't matter too much. Let me try this. 1 minus t times s. So that means at time t equal to 0, we have f. Okay? So this means we have f. And at time t equal 1,
we have f of 0, always f of 0, which is x 0, okay? This is a point.
Sorry, I wrote x 0, 0.
Here x 0 is 0, okay?
So the constant map is a point 0. This means that we have just one class, no? F.
Each class is this one. So this is a trivial group. That's again straight line homotopy, okay? That's what happens here. So you see how it gets smaller and smaller. So you retract here and then you retract here and then it gets smaller and smaller at the end. It's constant. That's the homotopy. You see how it. The loop goes to one point, okay? So this is one example, not interesting because trivial fundamental group, no? That's not very useful. So different passes, so definition. It's very formal still. So definition. It's a formalism. And then we have to find something which is not trivial, no? But then we have to work. And then we have some applications, okay? And then it might be useful. This is a formalism which is for the moment, it's not clear if it's interesting or not. So what?
Let alpha be a path. So we have two different
base points, okay?
In x from x0 to x1.
And then we define
alpha hat from pi 1 of x, x0 to pi 1 of x, x1.
So we have fundamental group of the same space, but with different base points, probably, maybe, okay, x0 and x1. And how do we find this? Well, alpha hat of a class f here.
So we have again this picture. So we have x0, x1. We have alpha. And now we have f here. Right?
And it's clear how to define this now. Now we want something based here, okay? What do? We take alpha minus 1.
Times
alpha, we go back, then we take f,
and then we go back again, so alpha. Or if you want to write it in a different way, it's alpha. Alpha minus 1 times f times alpha. That's the same.
And this minus 1 you may also write up, okay, out. Okay. Define alpha. Then alpha, so the definition is,
this is a lemma in definition. Definition. Then f. Then alpha hat is an isomorphism of groups. This is an isomorphism of groups.
So proof. Well, first you have to prove it's a homomorphism of groups, okay? So what does it mean? It means that alpha...
So let's see what we have to prove. Alpha hat of f times g is this is alpha hat of f times alpha hat of g.
Okay? That is homomorphism of groups, no? So what is this side?
This is alpha hat of f times g. This is a product.
And alpha hat always defined. This is alpha minus 1 times, well, I should have left this even, times f times g times alpha. That's the definition of alpha hat, no? First alpha minus 1, then the path, then alpha. This, on the other hand, what is this? This is alpha minus 1 times f times alpha. Sorry, I need more space. So this, I will go on here, okay? Here's the definition. Yeah. So this, well, I should write small. So this is alpha minus 1 times f times alpha. This is this. That's the definition. Times, and now that's the same for g, alpha minus 1 times g times alpha. Again, the definition.
Right? Two times the definition.
The parentheses in principle are these.
Okay.
That's the first, that's the second.
How?
If you use the class of alpha minus 1, it is not the same like the closed path. This alpha is not a closed path.
Alpha is not closed in general. No. Alpha goes
alpha
from.
Is not closed. The classes of.
Alpha is not closed.
Alpha is not closed.
No.
You use the same class.
Not closed. In general, it might be closed.
But in that's.
In general, it's not closed. That's not the closed path. Yeah.
Well, the class, the homotopy class of alpha, okay, of a non-closed path. That's we define. We have to fix. Okay.
So I go on here,
right, on this side, working on this side.
The lemma 1, 2, and 3 are proved for arbitrary passes, not for closed passes. Okay? So it's associative, the product, for arbitrary classes. Okay? The product must be defined, but then it's associative if it's defined. Okay? So I can put the parentheses in a different way, as I want, by associativity. So this is alpha minus 1 times, and now times f. I want to do it this way, of course.
This alpha, alpha minus 1, okay?
So times alpha minus 1. I'm not in a good shape here with the blackboard. And then we have what is remaining? G times alpha. Maybe this one, okay? But this, alpha, alpha minus 1, by the lemma, what is this? This is equal to C, which point? Alpha starts, x0. Okay? That's lemma. Three. And now I have something times Cx0, okay? And then I can forget this Cx0 by lemma 2, right? This is like behaves like a unit element. So this means I can forget, okay? So this means I can forget this part, right? By lemma 1, by lemma 2 and lemma 3, and associativity. So we use the three lemmas, which are not only for closed passes, okay? They are for arbitrary classes. So what remains is alpha minus 1 times f times g times alpha. And this is now finally equal to this, no? That's the other side. This alpha cancels in the mid, okay? Alpha and alpha minus 1, they cancel. It's not written nice because the blackboard, okay, but so we use
using lemma. We use all three. 1, 2, 3.
1 for associativity. We don't care about parentheses. 2 for this unit element, which we can forget, and 3 for inverse. Okay, so this is so it's a homomorphism. So this implies
alpha hat is a homomorphism of group.
Isomorphism. So now you can guess isomorphism, there's inverse one, okay? And what will be the inverse? The inverse isomorphism is so what do you suggest? Okay. And you can check this. I will not write. Okay. By the same, you use always these three. Okay. Easy to check. I don't want to write that also because it's the same as this. Okay. You just apply definition, and then you cancel what you can cancel, and then you see that you get what you want. Okay. So that's it. That's the definition of alpha hat, and alpha hat is an. This is important. Alpha hat is an isomorphism of groups. So this means that if X is path connected, okay.
So observation. If X is path nominally path connected. Then for all pairs, for all x0, x1 in x, pi1 of x, x0 is always isomorphic. So this means isomorphism now. To pi1 x, x1. It doesn't depend on the base part. The isomorphism class, okay?
If it's path connected. They are all isomorphic. However, there's a big, small problem here. The isomorphism in general is not canonic. It's not canonical, okay?
In general, you don't have a canonical isomorphism between, okay? The isomorphism is not canonical. What does it mean? Natural, I don't know.
It's not natural isomorphism. Natural or canonical? Well, it's the same for me. It's not a canonical. That is, it in general, it depends on the path alpha. Okay? Alpha, other, it depends on the path alpha. If you take another path, in general, you have a different isomorphism. Okay? In general, the isomorphism is not canonical, but depends
on the choice of the path alpha. That's what I say, but you have to believe this. Of the past, for the moment, I cannot prove this. I don't want to prove this. I say it's not canonical. Okay?
Then is you cannot identify these groups in a canonical way. Okay? It's not they are isomorphic, but you cannot say it's the same group. There's a famous example from linear algebra where you have isomorphism, not canonical, and canonical isomorphism. Somebody. Remember what that is? Between vectors, you have a vector space, and then you have a canonical isomorphism with another vector space. You have an isomorphism. In any case, isomorphism for vector spaces means they have the same dimension, okay? But then you go one step further, and then you get the canonical isomorphism. What is this? So you go to the dual, okay? If you have a vector space of finite dimension, V, okay? Then you have the dual, V star. And this has the same dimension. So V is, so remark, just to give you a feeling what is canonical and non-canonical. So V is a vector space now. Finite dimension, okay? Finite dimension. Then V star, the dual, has the same dimension, okay? Same dimension. The dual has the same dimension as the vector space, if it's finite dimensional, okay? So they are isomorphic. Two vector spaces are isomorphic if and only if they have the same dimension, okay? So they are isomorphic.
Isomorphic.
Because they have the same dimension, no? But this isomorphism, in general, you cannot choose in a canonical way. You cannot identify this, okay? But what can you identify? What? Yes, exactly. So I go on one further step. I take the dual of the dual, no? This is the dual of the dual, okay? B bi dual, I don't know English. B, bi dual, okay?
How do you pronounce bi, I suppose, no?
Bi dual. And now this and this are isomorphic, you can identify. They are isomorphic in a canonical way.
V isomorphic to V, the bi dual,
so here you have a canonical isomorphism. So you canonical.
Isomorphism.
Here you have a canonical isomorphism. And then you can identify using this, okay? So then you say almost that it's the same. You don't distinguish. Equal. They're not equal, but you can identify in a canonical way, so it's the same. Okay? That you cannot do here. You need some choice here. You need the choice of a basis, and then you have the dual basis. And then you use the isomorphism. If you choose another basis, then you get a different isomorphism, okay? So you don't know how to fix, okay? So now we're doing linear algebra, okay? What is the canonical isomorphism here?
What?
Well, that's not our theme. So you have, this is conceptual a little bit, the bi-dual, okay? You apply, so if you have something, how to call this? V in the bi-dual, okay? The dual of the dual. And you have a phi in the dual. Then you have V, you can apply this. Well, let's forget this. I don't want to do linear algebra. I just want to say that there are isomorphisms and canonical isomorphisms, okay? And the most famous example is that this is not canonical in general, but this is canonical. So you identify these, okay? This is the same. And here is the same. You have an isomorphism, but in general you cannot choose it in a canonical way, okay? Because you have to choose this path alpha. And if you choose another alpha, you have another isomorphism. So you cannot identify, really, okay? So this is a similar situation, okay. What is next? Definition.
Well, just a way of talking to the function. X is simply connected. If X is path connected, and the fundamental root of X, X0, is trivial.
And this does not depend on the choice of X0, okay? Because we have path connected, okay?
Does not depend. This triviality on the choice of X0.
So this is simply connected. Path connected and trivial fundamental group, okay? Simply connected is path connected and trivial fundamental. If it's not path connected, this is also maybe a useful remark. If it's not path connected, then let's say we have two path components, okay? Just a remark, trivial remark, but.
So remark. To give you a feeling, maybe. If X has, for example, has two path components, so here's one path component, here's the other one. This is A, B. Path components A and B.
Okay.
And now you choose the base point here, A0, in the one component. And then you choose the base point B0, okay?
Then these two fundamental groups are completely independent. Then the fundamental group of
then pi 1 of x with base point a0. This, by the way, is then pi 1 of a with base point a0, no?
Because you a path in x which starts here never goes to zero. Okay? You don't have a path from here to here. So also if you have a closed path here, you cannot pass to this side, okay? Because otherwise, you have a path from here to here, okay?
Then pi 1 of x a and pi 1 of x b0. This is pi 1 of b b0.
Are completely independent, okay? Are independent. One has nothing to do with the other.
Independent. So this means
one that has absolutely nothing to do with the other. Okay,
so you cannot suppose that
we have to prove non-trivial fundamental groups. But if we have, then we take a space with one fundamental group and here a space with another fundamental group. Okay, then you take the disjoint union, and then it depends on the base point. Okay, so it's useful for. It does not depend if it's path connected. Path connected is the important point, okay? If it's path connected, then the fundamental group up to isomorphism is independent of the base point. Okay. Now to finish all this, so here's a last exercise.
The next exercise, exercise 3.
If X is simply connected,
this is all easy. If X is simply connected, then
any two paths with the same initial point and also the same final point are paths on the top.
Then any two paths with the same initial point And the same final point also. Pass homotopic. So we have two passes, no? You have two passes here which have the same initial point and the same final point, okay? F and G. And if it's simply connected with this definition here, then any two passes, these are not closed now, okay? F and G. Not closed. It doesn't matter. Okay, this is exercise 3 for next week. So to finish all this now, I have to, this is a functor, okay, fundamental group. So it goes on with these formalities, but well. Of course, one would like to see a non-trivial fundamental group, but maybe I should write this theorem, which is the first theorem we should prove, but not now. Theorem. Pi 1 of S1, this is a unit sphere, okay? With any base point, x0, what would you so this is S1. Here's a base point. And now, what would you suspect? What is this fundamental group?
Z.
Yes. And why Z? So you have a path, okay? And you start running around, okay? And what you count is the number of, how many times? The rotation number, okay? And this is this integer, okay? Maybe this is 1. This is minus 1. This is 2. Okay? This is minus 2. And so on. However, a path can be really very, very complicated, no? So this is not trivial. So a path goes in this direction, then in this direction, then in this direction, then it returns, and it does very strange things, okay? So how to define the rotation number. You are doing complex analysis, no? There's also some kind of rotation number, okay? By some integral or something, right? Now we are coming to this topology. So this is a proof, okay? But not today.
Tomorrow.
Not tomorrow. Whenever. Next week. So definition. Other definition. I want a functor. Let h from x0, from x to y be continuous. We have a continuous map. So it has to preserve base points. So I choose base points x0 and base point y0. So we define h star, the induced map, from pi 1 of x0 to pi 1 of y0. I want to define a mapping, okay? So how to define h star of f? So what do you suggest? We have a path in x, and we apply h, and we have a path in so we take f times h. This is an element here. It's a homomorphism of groups. It's a homomorphism of groups. The homomorphism induced by H, okay? The homomorphism induced.
a continuous map. Well, the proof is, this is... it's a homomorphic. First, it's well defined, okay? Maybe you think, well, I use representative, okay? H is well defined.
That's maybe the first, even, it's well defined. But why is it well defined? So if F is homotopic to G, to F prime,
okay,
then F H, which is this definition, okay, and F prime H, which is, they should be homotopic.
Also, no? It doesn't depend on the representatives, okay?
And what is the homotopy? So we have homotopy here. What is this homotopy? H? H.
Very clear. No, this is always H, okay? So you just compose everything as H. This means it's well defined. This is homotopy between these two, okay? So it's well defined. Then it's homomorphism. H star of
homomorphism of groups. So F times G is equal to what? H star of F times H star of G.
That's what we have to prove, right?
So let's work on this. So this is what? H star of F is HF. H star of G is first G, then H. That's the definition, two types, okay? And here we have the product. And I say this is equal to H times F, of course, this is equal to HF, and then HG.
Okay. By the definition, no? You take representatives and it takes it.
But this is equal to
and now you see that this is H times F times G. Also without homotopy, okay? So this is a triviality, okay?
H times F times H times G, composition.
This is a product, this is a composition, okay?
Is equal to H composition F times G. They are equal even,
without the parentheses, okay? Even without the parentheses, they are equal this. Here you take first the product and then compose with H. Here you first compose with H both and then take the product. The result is the same. So this is equal to this, and this is of course this. H star from this is by definition, okay? So they are equal, yes. It's a homomorphism of groups. This is a group homomorphism. What else? It's a homomorphism of groups. But, so that's what we say, okay? So it's a homomorphism of groups. And now we have the functorial properties.
Functorial properties.
Of the fundamental group.
So we have this situation. We have H. We have mapping from. So this is the first one. We have a continuous map F from X to Y and G from Y to Z.
We have a composition, no?
And we have the base points. F of x0 is y0, and g of y0 is z0, okay? The base points are preserved. And then f, first f and then g star, the induced map, is equal to f star.
So this says that the induced map of a composition is a composition of the induced maps, okay? Right? The induced map of a composition is the composition of the induced maps, okay? That's the first property.
Very simple.
And the second property is even more simple. That says if you take the identity map of a space, okay? Identity map of X. So this is the identity map. This means every point goes to itself, okay? The identity of X star, the adduced map, is the identity map of the fundamental group, okay? Pi 1, x, x0. This is the second functorial. These are the two functorial properties. The second one is trivial. If you take a path and you compose with the identity map of x, you have the same path. Okay? So it's the identity of this. If you take a path and compose with the identity h before, okay, then you don't change the path, no? You have the same path again. So it's the identity also of the fundamental group, okay? And this will prove, how much time do I have? 10 minutes. Proof. Well, it's also trivial, no? What is it really? So G times F star of I'm in bad shape, no? The path was always F, no? Now we have a continuous map F here, okay, and G. So now I have to change notation the path. W, okay? Right? That's the path. These, sorry, are continuous maps, of course. I forgot. These are continuous maps. Everything is continuous. Yeah. So well, how is this defined? This is W, and then we compose with this, no? That's the definition of the induced map. However, the composition of maps is associative, no? Not of classes, of maps. So this is WF and then G. In fact, this is equal to this, without the parentheses also, okay? We don't need the parentheses. So what is this? This is G star of F times W. Right, by the definition of G star. And this is G star of so x equal this is equal to G star of F star of W. By the definition of F star. And so this is first F star and then G star of W. And that's what we want to prove. Ah, yes, no. I started with W, okay? And this implies for each W, okay? So this means this map and this map are the same. So this implies for each argument, they are the same. So this is equal to this F star times G star. Since for each argument, they are the same, they are the same. Two maps are the same if for each argument they have the same value. Okay? So this is I. 2i is even more trivial. Now I have still a little bit of time. But this is
so identity map of X of W. How is this defined? This is W identity map of X. Okay?
That's the definition.
But the identity map doesn't change anything,
so it's W again, okay?
So this means that sorry. Identity map
star of that's
so this means identity map X induced map is the identity map of pi 1 of X, X0. Okay.
If you compose this identity, nothing changes, in other words, okay? If you compose this identity, nothing changes. And in the first one, if you compose with the composition, you can do it step by step, okay? By associativity of composition, right? So these are almost trivial things, okay? And then nevertheless, they are important. These two functorial properties, so I give the last thing for today.
Yes. I give, so these are the two functorial properties.
The composition, the induced map of a composition is equal to the composition of the induced maps, and the induced map of the identity map of a space is the identity map of its fundamental group. Okay?
Very simple stuff. However, now we have the first short application. So,
theorem.
If f from x to y is a homeomorphism, so we have, I need base points always. This f of x0 is equal to y0.
If you have a homeomorphism,
then what you suspect is that the induced map from pi 1 x, x0 to pi 1 y, y0, they have to preserve base points, okay? It's an isomorphism.
Okay, a homeomorphism induces a continuous map induces a homeomorphism.
A homeomorphism induces an isomorphism. Okay, proof. Very simple. So what means homeomorphism?
We have an inverse continuous map. Okay,
let f g from y to x be the inverse. Map of G, of F, also continuous. That's not automatic, okay? Also continuous. By definition. This is definition. For some spaces, we don't, we have a bijection, and then the inverse map is also, for what spaces?
Compact spaces. There we don't, but for general spaces, the inverse of a bijective continuous map is not continuous, okay? But if it's compact, yes. So we have to ask it. This inverse map of F, also continuous by definition, okay?
So this means that first F and then G is what? Is the identity map of X. And first G and then F is the identity map of Y, right? And now applies to, so this implies first f and then g star, this is trivial, is equal to the identity map of x star. No? If the two maps are equal, the induced maps are equal, right? Clear. But now this is f star, and this is this. This is a property, okay? The induced map of a composition is the composition of the induced map.
And the induced map of the identity map is the identity of the fundamental group. This is a star, no? Maybe sometimes. Okay. Similarly.
Now you do the other one. You have G star and then F star is the identity map of pi 1 of y 0.
And that means that F star is an isomorphism with inverse to G star. Okay? So this says
F star is an isomorphism. With inverse isomorphism G star. So in some sense, you can write this way if you want. You say F star minus 1 is F minus 1 star. No.
The inverse map of F star is the... Oops. Yeah. Okay. The inverse... okay, this. The inverse map of F star is, well, whatever it is. So, last remark. So, this means
last remark.
If x and y are path connected, so this means the fundamental group does not depend on the base points, okay? If they are path connected,
pi 1 of x, x 0, and I take any base point, is not isomorphic to pi 1 of y 0, then x and y are not homeomorphic, okay? Then x and y are not homeomorphic. There are no homeomorphism.
In the other say, if x and y are homeomorphic, then the fundamental groups are isomorphic. That's the same, right? If they are homeomorphic, then the fundamental groups are isomorphic. If the fundamental groups are not isomorphic, then the spaces are not homeomorphic. So in this sense, a fundamental group is an algebraic invariant, is a topological invariant. Okay, the first example of a topological. We have topological properties, no? If you have two spaces, one is Hausdorff, the other not, they are not homeomorphic. Okay, if you have two spaces, path connected, no, and the fundamental groups are not the same, isomorphic. They are not homeomorphic, okay? So this is the first example. So the fundamental group is an example. Of an algebraic invariant, a topological invariant. Not property, no, invariant, okay? Invariant means something algebraic, okay? So the fundamental group is an example of a topological invariant for path-connected spaces, okay? For path-connected spaces. So compare with topological property, okay? Hausdorff, first countable, second countable, compact, path connected, connected. Okay. Now we have a first example of a topological, not property, but invariant, which is a group, the fundamental group. Okay. And there are many invariants. I mean, the next one is homology of all type, cohomology, homology. These are all topological invariants. Okay. homology, cohomology. And maybe numbers, but that's more difficult to define. Euler number is one also, okay? That's a number even, okay? But these are algebraic. So topological invariant of algebraic type, okay? Not a property. It's something algebraic now. In this sense, fundamental group is a functor. So that's the last. Well,
fundamental group. Fundamental group. The fundamental group is a functor. So fundamental group means pi 1 x, x 0.
Okay, that's a group. But also this H star, okay? The maps, we need also the maps.
Induced maps H star,
both, okay?
Fundamental is a functor from the category. Well, that's a way to say something. It's a, from the category of topological spaces with base points. To the category of groups. From the category of topological with base points and continuous base points preserving maps, okay? And continuous base point preserving maps to the category of
what? Groups and group homomorphisms.
So a category of groups and group homomorphisms. That's a way to say it. Not, and group homomorphisms. Or if we have a continuous map X, Y, H continuous and preserves a base point, then we continuous H of x0 is y0, base point preserving we need. Then this gives me H star in the other category, and this goes from pi 1 x, x0 to pi 1 y, y0. So we go from one category to the other category. The category of topological spaces with base points and continuous maps to the category of groups and group homomorphisms, okay? And if this is a homeomorphism, then this is an isomorphism, okay? This is just a way of talking, that's not so important, okay? What is more important, what we will do next week? Because now we have this is a formalism, right? If you say it's important, but it's also boring maybe because we have no application, no? We just define something and define. Next week, we have to compute some group. The first one is of this circle, okay? And then give some nice applications. So then we see if that is useful, okay, fundamental group, okay? This is, up to this point, it might be that all fundamental groups are trivial, no, for example. Then we have to prove first something, okay? If all would be trivial, that's nothing. Then we can forget, okay, fundamental groups. But that's not the case. And the last remark, I never said that the fundamental group is abelian, okay? This is, in general, is not abelian. It's a general group, okay? That makes it difficult, fundamental group. Abelian groups are easy, finitely generated. Then they are easy. General groups are very difficult, okay? Non-abelian groups can be very difficult. So we will see examples, okay, in the next 2 weeks. 2 weeks left. Okay.